Hello friends, welcome back to Easy Engineering by Neha Sayed. Today's topic in this video that we are going to see is an fiber distributed data interface, mostly known as FDDI. Okay, see, it allows the transmission of data in a local area network over a fiber optic cable. It is a set of NCN ISO standard. It can be used where LAN can be extended up to 200 kilometers, or you can say it can be extended up to 124 miles. Okay, see, 200 kilometers or 124 miles in diameter. As fiber optic cables are used here, obviously the speed, or you can say transmission rate, is going to be very high, and it supports the transmission rate or data transmission rate can be up to 200 Mbps. And it uses a dual ring strategy to transmit the data, whereas first ring, what is there are, as I have told you, there are two rings, primary ring and a secondary ring. Why the primary ring is used? It is responsible for transmission of data or a frame, or you can say for the transmission of message from one point to another point, and the speed used here can be up to 100 Mbps. Whereas secondary ring, in case primary ring fails, secondary ring is used to recover all the failures, means it is used for the backup and recovery purpose. So this is the two rings, or you can say we use this dual ring strategy. Okay, there are different topologies can be used, or different topologies are supported in FDDI. What are the topologies? Ring, star and tree. And it also supports up to 1000 nodes and a stations, means we can connect up to 1000 nodes or a stations. Okay, because of that, we can say that it has become the backbone of wide area network. See, using this simple figure or a diagram, you can see there are two different ring, primary ring and a secondary ring. Obviously both are going to be rotated in a opposite direction. Primary ring is mainly used for the transmission of data, whereas secondary ring is used for the backup purpose. So these are the two different ring which are going to be used. In this figure, you can see it is an elaborated of this figure. As I have written nodes here, I have specified what are these nodes. It can be server, it can be concentrator, or it can be router. So it can be anything, okay? But we have to remember, we have to use two rings, and that both the rings are going to be rotated in an opposite direction. See, as I have told you, primary ring carries the data between the system, while secondary ring is used for the redundancy purpose. Okay, if system on the network causes any kind of interruption in a primary ring or a primary data path, the secondary ring is used until the secondary ring can be used until primary ring is going to be recovered. Means it works similar like a token ring. Okay, so to fix the if there is no fixed direction for primary and secondary ring, but it has to be in an opposite direction. There is no restriction like it has to be in this direction only or it has to be in this direction only, but it has to be in an opposite direction. Means primary ring is, if it rotating in this direction, then secondary ring has to be rotated in an opposite direction. Okay, see, there are two different kind of stations that we should know. As you can see, first one is a SAS and second one is a DAS. See, what is SAS? It is a single attached station, and where it DAS is a double attached station. Single attached station means what? It is attached to a single ring, where it is going to be attached to both the ring. It is going to be attached at both ring. And it is going to be attached to a single ring. Okay, see how this FDDI works. As I have told you, it uses a token ring protocol, means it works similar like a token ring. For this, you can also prefer my token ring lecture for more understanding, but still I will simplify it for you. It contains two rings. The first ring is going to be used for the transmission of data, and the second ring is going to be used for the backup purpose. So if any station wants to send the data, the particular station is going to hold the packet, hold the token, and it is going to insert all the information, and then ring is going to be rotated in the that particular token is going to be rotated in that ring, and whatever the destination is there, the destination address is going to accept that particular token or the in frame, and it removes, or you can say it copies the message and it empties the frame, and again that particular token is going to be rotated in that respective frame. Once the ring is received by the, or once the ring is reached by the sender, at a sender, the sender checks the frame. It checks whether the frame is empty or not. If it the frame is empty, it take it as an acknowledgement that the data has been received at a destination site. So this is way, this is the way how the token ring works. So similarly, FDDI also works. You can see this is a basic frame format for the FDDI. As you can see, first one is a PA. PA means it is a preamble. It is a unique sequence for preparing the station for the upcoming frame or a token. Next field is a start delimiter. It means it marks the beginning of a frame. Next is a destination address. Obviously, it is going to contain the destination address. I think I have forgotten this. This is an this is nothing but a frame control. See, it is used for controlling the frame, or it is used for data control. It is a 1-byte frame. It specifies whether this is a data frame or it is a control frame. So this frame is going to specify whether it is a control, complete frame is a control frame or a data frame. And the, this one is the source address. Obviously, it is going to contain the address of a source or a sender. And this is a variable field, or you can say that it is having a variable length. And obviously, the information or actual data is going to be in this. Next is a checksum. It is used for error correction and discarding damaged frame. And the last field, it is again of 1 byte. It is a end delimiter and a frame status. See, if it defines the end of frame, and a frame status is obviously going to show the status of a frame, whether the receiver has copied the message or not. As I have told you, it works like a token ring. Means once the message is received by the receiver or a destination, it copies the message and it set the frame status as message has been received, and that particular frame, empty frame or a empty token is going to be again rotated. And if it is reached to the sender, if sender sees it is empty, means it takes as an acknowledgement, and it also sees the frame status, and again the token is going to be rotated in the same direction. In the same direction of, you can say it rotates in the rings. So this is the way how the FDDI works. I hope you understand. If you like the video, don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Thank you.